Today we'll be talking about premarital counseling. Premarital counseling will relate to two types of counseling. That will be psychological counseling and the medical counseling. So I'll be dealing with the medical counseling part. Psychological counseling, you'll be needing a counselor if there are some issues related to some emotional bonding, or you want to have a counseling before your want that your married life should be healthy in that way. So you can take a psychological counseling with the counselor. For the medical part, what the most important thing is that we want that both the partners should be healthy after marriage. As we go for horoscope checking for all before a marriage, we know that horoscope will not lead us to have a healthy married life. What needs us to a healthy married life is getting ourselves checked. Both the female and the male should go to a gynecologist or some doctor and get all the investigations done, especially the infected diseases like the STDs, HIV, hepatitis, HCV, VDRL, syphilis. These diseases should be checked. We don't know whether our partners, though he might be a very good person, he might be from a very good background, he might be very healthy to look at, might be suffering from some disease which he himself doesn't know. So better go get those tests done. You can discuss with the gynecologist and then get your test done and your partner's test done. If you do this beforehand, you will be more sure that your partner is more healthy, and whenever you're going into a sexual relationship with your partner, you will be much safer. So the other aims of premarital counseling will be the sexual education. The most important thing the female suffers is she is very anxious about the first night. They are not aware, the couple is going for the sexual relationship for the first time. So they are not aware of any type of contraception. So contraception is also a second part. So you should talk to your partner before you are getting married that whether you are going for a family or you are not going for a family. You don't want a pregnancy for a year or 2 years or 6 months, or you just want to, don't know, most of our couples who come to us are conceiving and they are not planned. They are not aware that they will be conceiving or not conceiving. And then they conceive and then there are problems, then they have an issue whether they want to abort or then they want to continue their pregnancy. So aborting is also not right, and continuing the pregnancy without a proper planning, and the mother is not, maybe her education is not completed, maybe her education is still to be completed and she doesn't want to have a baby right now, but then the family pressure is there and she conceives and then continues the pregnancy. Half of the pregnancy goes in lot of vomiting, anxiety, and then she's not taking care of herself. Then there is chances of having a preterm delivery, mortality, the morbidity of the baby will be more, the weight of the baby will be less. So we should avoid such issues. So in that case, if the sexual education, contraception education and the discussion with the partner has already happened, so these things will be avoided. So, and many times you are hesitant to talk to your partner. If you come to the doctor with your partner, or you can have a one-to-one discussion with your doctor, no need to sit together, but if you sit together, it will be a very good thing. So these things are taken care in the premarital counseling. And then the education for the infections. If you are already suffering from some infection, you should talk to your doctor, you should get it treated so that you both of them don't have the same infection. Many people have warts, then they transmit it to their partners, and then the disease flares up in both the partners, and then they get treated after that. I have had many patients who have both the partners had the warts after their first sexual contact, and we had to treat both of them. If one would have come with the same problem before they had a sexual relationship, we could have prevented that thing to flare up in both the partners. And then actually after you suffer from such a disease, there is always an anxiety before you go for a relationship, because you know, you go for the next time you are into the relationship, you are very anxious. So to prevent these, you should meet your doctor. And if you are a doctor and you have planned that you are going for your pregnancy right after you have married, so then you should take the preconceptional counseling also. Because preconceptual counseling, we go for investigations, we take your history, we stop any drugs you are taking which can be malformed for the which can cause malformation to the baby. So these things should be catered, and there will be a full preconceptual counseling. Even your vaccine history, it should be taken. And all those who are going for premarital counseling, they can even also go for a cervical cancer vaccine if they have not taken it before. And you can get your investigations and your partner's investigations to be done. And you should know about condoms, you should know about contraceptive pills, you should know about emergency contraception. What is emergency contraception? Many times people come to me very late and they have gone over the time when they can have taken an emergency contraception also. If you take an emergency contraception in time, you can prevent yourself from pregnancy. Because once you have conceived, you have to go through the abortion process. And that is very heartening for both the partners. It's not an easy thing. You go through emotional challenge and a medical challenge both. And before ending, I would like to tell you one case in my history in which by both the partners, they became HBS antigen positive. And one of the partners, they became HIV positive just after conceiving. And then they had to go for a divorce because of that, because they thought that the other partner had not told the history to them. And there was one of my couples who conceived, and they came to me for termination at 10 weeks. And they terminated, but she came to me after 2 years and she had not disclosed the history. And then she came, told me that she had been HIV positive and she terminated the baby. But now, because her husband was not well, she wanted to have another baby. But right now it was not the time. So I just want you all to know that if you are hepatitis B positive or HIV positive, the times have come that we can prevent the baby from getting that malformation. In HIV positive, you can go for an IUI or an IVF and you can have a healthy baby. And in case of hepatitis B, there are lots of medications by which your baby can be prevented from having the same infection. So please disclose these to your doctors. Meet your doctor beforehand. Talk to your partner. Talk to your. You should not no need to disclose it to every relative, but you can always disclose this to your partner and to your doctor. And please, all of those people, best of luck for their marriage, and they should go for a premarital counseling. And we have this facility at Manipal, so please come over and take this before you are getting married and get yourself investigated.